Good morning, YouTube. So during this video, I just wanted to educate you guys on how to actually read labels and how to actually spot shady protein bars, shady meal prep companies, things like that. So just a few things that I wanted to preface before I actually started this video. I'm not going to be mentioning any company names. The point of this video is not to bash any company. It's simply to educate you guys on how to actually spot a shady bar or a shady product or something that just doesn't add up when it comes to the macros and the calories. So I won't be mentioning any company names. I will actually blur out any sort of labels or any sort of indicators when it comes to the actual bars that I'm going to be showing you guys. I have five different examples that I want to go through with you guys, and some are great and some are not so great. And unfortunately, in this day and age, in order to have a business, you need to make sales. And in order to make sales, you need to be better than your competition. And in order to be better than your competition, sometimes you make false claims. And sometimes you misrepresent the calories and the macros that are on your bar just to make yourself look better than the next person. And unfortunately, this happens quite a bit, especially in the bodybuilding industry. And we do not sell a protein bar. I'm not here to pitch you guys on our bars, say, oh, we're so much better. We do not sell protein bars. As of right now, we do not sell protein bars. So I'm not doing that. I'm simply trying to educate you guys, because you might see all these fit people eating these bars or these meals or these meal prep companies or anything like that. And just because they're eating it doesn't mean that the companies are being honest with you, the customer, on the macros and the calories that are actually in the bar itself or the meal or whatever the case may be. So I just wanted to take, you know, probably it'd be about 10 minutes just educating you guys on how to actually spot a company and their shady products, or not shady products, because a lot of companies do really have really, really, really good products out there. They just might not be marketed like the other ones. So I just want you guys to be self-aware. I just want you to have some education and some baseline when you are going to the grocery store. I personally just like making my own protein bars, as you guys have seen on our YouTube, that I just like making my own stuff because I then know the ingredients that are going into it. And so then I know the macros and I know what I'm putting in my body is exactly what's listed. So that, but then all of that being said, would I much rather you have a protein bar that's misrepresenting their calories than going to Burger King or McDonald's? Yes. Absolutely. So you just have to find that balance. And this goes for protein powders. This goes for anything, any sort of shakes or any sort of pre-made shakes or powders or whatever the case may be. This literally is just not, you know, only true when it comes to protein bars. This is true when it comes to all processed foods. And that's what protein bars are, is processed foods. You need to remember that. So if you do need to supplement your protein, I personally would rather do a powder over a bar. There's just a lot less ingredients when it comes to a protein powder. Whole food is always going to be best. So if you do have the option between picking a protein bar or picking up a piece of, you know, grilled chicken, I would always recommend the grilled chicken, just because it is a whole food and it is a more natural source of protein. Sometimes though, we don't have the options. So I just want you guys to be educated. We're going to start this. And just to reiterate again, I'm not going to bash any companies. I'm not going to say any company names. I'm going to erase all indicators that, you know, of the bars that I am going to show you guys. I do have five examples. Some are good, some are not. Some are close to being perfect. Okay, so let's get started. I just wanted to preface all of those things. I'm not here to bash anyone. I am not here to call anyone out. I'm simply here to educate you guys and hopefully make this a lifelong skill that you can then use whenever you're shopping at the grocery store. It doesn't take a lot of time. It's very simple once you understand the basic principles. So that's what we're gonna learn right now. Okay, so basic principles. When you are looking at nutrition labels, you need to remember that protein has 4 calories per gram, carbs has 4 calories per gram, and then fat has 9 calories per gram. So what does this mean? So let's just take a very simple example, and let's just say this bar has 10 protein, 10 carbs, and 5 fat. So then you would multiply times 4, times 4, times 9, and this should equal the total calories. So that means 40 of your calories are coming from protein, 40 of your calories are coming from carbs, and 45 of your calories are coming from fat. So the total calories of this bar should be 125. Some companies claim that fiber, you should subtract the fiber from the carbs and only count net carbs. And some companies claim that certain sugars shouldn't be counted in carbs and things like that. But even if you follow all of their rules, it still doesn't add up. I personally just feel like you should count total carbs in your total because you're eating them. Sometimes, yes, there is a lot of fiber in things, but nutrition labels unfortunately do not differentiate between soluble and insoluble fiber. So it's really difficult to say and to claim, oh, you just shouldn't count all the fiber, when if it's half and half, insoluble and soluble, your body's still processing some of that and you're still getting calories from some of that fiber. So for me, I just wish companies would be honest and just put the entire carbs that are actually on there. Now that you know basic math, just absorb that, okay? So we just add the protein, the carbs, and the fat, times it by your 4, 4, and 9, and add them up. So this should be, in our little example, 125 calories for the entire bar, or the entire serving, whatever this is. So now let's actually get to the protein bars that I have. This one, like I said, I'm not here to call anyone out. So this one bar is 160 calories, 7 fat, 18 carbs, and 15 proteins. So let's write that down. Now you can obviously just do this in your calculator, but for visual purposes, I just wanted to write it down for you guys. All right, so we have 160 calories. We have 15 protein, 18 carbs, and 7 fat. You add all of those up. Oh, all right. 195 versus 160 that's actually listed. If I had to guess, this company is trying to claim that all of their fiber is actually insoluble, so that means your body can't absorb it, so you shouldn't count it in your total macros, because their fiber is listed as 10 grams. So if you were to subtract 10 times 4 calories, so 40, your 195 minus your 40 would equal 155. However, not all fiber is insoluble. And so for a company to misrepresent that on their label that drastically is pretty bad. So it's not the worst I've ever seen. However, 35 calories when you are cutting can make a big difference. And these numbers are not going to make some sort of astronomical difference for you guys. However, if you're eating 10 bars a week, that 35 calories that isn't accounted for is still 350 calories. That's 1/10 of a pound. So if you are really trying to cut weight, or if you're trying to get ready for a show or anything like that, these small numbers can add up over time. So just something to keep in mind. Okay, so our next example is 190 calories, 6 fat, 22 carbs, and 15 protein. 22 carbs, 15 protein, and 6 fat. This one actually might be pretty close. So this one is 202 compared to the 190 that they had listed. So not horrible, definitely not horrible, definitely better option between the two because there is only a 12 calorie difference. So again, this one is claiming that there's 5 grams of fiber in there. And lots of sugar, alcohols, and things like that. Again, what I was referencing earlier, some companies will try to say, if you ever bring this up to them, they'll say, oh, you need to count so much percentage of your sugar alcohols and so much percentage of your fiber and things, you know, things like that. So again, it's all about getting those calories as low as possible on these bars to try to look better than your competition. So for the next three, I'm just going to do them straight on the calculator for you guys. Okay, this is a popular one. I'm not going to name names, but it is popular. All right, lots of fat in these. So 205 calories, 13 fat, 10 carbs, and 13 protein. So because carbs and protein are the same, you can just add up the grams. So you've got your 13 protein and 10 carbs, which is what I did, times, so it's 23. Then you can just multiply that by 4. So you've got 92 calories right there, and then you just remember that number. So we had 13 fat, 117 plus 92 from before, 209. So this one, out of all of them, gets my highest stamp of approval. Again, I am not sponsored by any of these brands. I don't have any personal vendettas against any of these brands. These were simply ones that I know are popular, especially in the bodybuilding community and the fat loss community, that I see people eating quite a bit. So I'm not here to bash anyone. I am not here to promote anyone. I am simply here to educate you guys. If you know the brands, that is great. If not, hey, that's okay. Just be educated. This next one, again, pretty popular. 240 calories. Wow, 17 fat, 10 carbs, and 20 protein. Our 20 protein plus our 10 carbs. So you multiply it by 4, that means 120 of your calories are coming from carbs and protein. Then we had 17 fat times 9 calories. Plus your 120 from before, 273. So this one is overshooting by 33 calories, which again, hi Jerry. Which again, doesn't seem like a lot, but if you're eating 10 of these packets a week, that's 1/10 of a pound that you could have lost had you just picked up a different protein bar. So over the course of a year, if you are trying to lose a substantial amount of weight, 1/10 of a pound a week, over 52 weeks is still 5 pounds. So it might not seem like a lot. It might not seem like a lot to you guys. 30 calories here, 30 calories there, things like that. But if you're eating, like I said, 10 a week, or say if you're eating 3 or 4 processed foods that don't add up and they're undershooting their calories a day, you still might be dieting, but you might not be getting the results that you want. Then you're gonna get discouraged, you're gonna quit. Things like that. So let's finish our last one. This one was actually the one I thought was closest. So in here, there's actually 2 servings, but the calories are for 1 serving. So we're just going to do 1 serving because that's what you're supposed to eat, is 1 serving. So we have 180 calories, 8 fat, 17 carbs, and 8 protein. So we have our 17 carbs plus our 8 protein. And we times that by 4. Obviously, that's going to be 100. And then our fat, which is 8 times 9 plus 100 equals 172. So this one actually undershot, which is why I remembered liking them. Because to undershoot is like the best thing in the world. You obviously want to be as close as you can get, but undershooting is better than overshooting. So again, you can do this with protein bars, protein powder, protein shakes, meal prep companies, anything like that. Just to make sure that the company that you're investing into and the company that you're giving your money to and the company that you're eating is actually being honest with you guys. As long as they're being honest, as long as they're close, as long as they are close, but being more than 10% off. So if something's 200 calories and they're more than 20 calories off, that is a problem. 10% off or more on your macros is very, very, very wrong from a moral standpoint, from a food standpoint, from my standpoint. I would not feel good as a company if I was that off. I would want to be as honest with my customers as I could be to get it exact. So I hope this helped you guys. The rest of this clip, you'll see just some sporadic workouts, errands, things like that. I just wanted to preface this for you guys and just give you, like I said, that basis and knowledge that hopefully will be a lifelong skill. So if you have any questions, definitely comment below. Like I said, I'm not going to promote protein bars as I'm not working with anyone currently. There are a lot of really good options out there. Like I just showed you guys 2 good examples and 3 bad examples. And I hope this helps. It's very quick. It's very easy. Now that you have this baseline foundation, you can go to the store. You can add it up on your calculator real quick. And if it's less than 10% difference, they get an okay from me. So I hope this helps. Like I said, comment below if you have any questions. And we'll see you guys in the next clip.
I don't know.
Cross and stay up. Now lean forward.
Okay.
There it is. Cross. Lean forward. Push your feet out to the side.
This way.
Yeah, baby. Oh. Yeah, there you go.
So forward, lift your toes to cross your toes.
It is beautiful. And then work on straightening your legs.
Okay.
Now use that leg as a lever. Yeah.
There you go.
There it is.
That looks cool.
Beautiful.
There you go.
Under. So whichever hand you're reaching around, that's the leg. Yeah, that's good. Perfect. Both of you. Okay. So this is your pose.
Yeah, I like this one a lot.
So watch your hand come down to the floor. Bend through your standing leg. Yes. Oh, okay. Yeah. So that's always
a lot of these. You have to think about swallowing your spine with your scapula.
We just left Harbor Yoga Studio here in Columbus, and Angie is awesome. She taught us so many fun arm balance poses, standing poses, all that jazz, because we leave for Bali on Friday. So it was tough. It was hot. I think it was like, it felt like it was 400 degrees in there, but it was good. It helps you loosen up, opens your hips, just relaxes your muscles. And Josh mastered chin pose, which was pretty cool.
Was it called Scorpion or something?
So it was an awesome private yoga session. Now we are off to run some errands, go to the chiropractor, go to the gym. I think that's it for the day as far as errands go. So should be a good day. We're going to take you guys along with us. It's raining, it's dreary, but that's all right because it's kind of warm. So
I isolated back today, and what I like to do, I split my arms and my back days. However, I lift my arms, so I lifted arms yesterday and then I lifted back today. So a lot of times when you're lifting back, if your arms are fresh, your arms will actually take over the workload, and then your back is targeted as your secondary or even your tertiary muscle group. So if you exhaust your arms, either if you only lift a few days a week, you could do arms and back together, but definitely lift arms first, or do arms the day before like I did. Your arms are tired, so your back will be more isolated and more targeted. So like I said, today I did back. My back workout was, I did 4 rounds of 10 narrow pull downs, 10 wide pull downs, and then 10 rows. So what that means, as you'll see in the video, I did 10 narrow, 10 wide, then 10 rows, and then I took a rest. About 1 to 2 minutes, and then I did it again, and again, and again. So always just make sure you're not resting in between the exercises until you actually finish the round.
Thank you.
was upright rows on the hyper machine, and I did 10 reps, and I did that three times. So I just did the 10 reps, again rested 1 to 2 minutes, and I completed that three rounds total. And for that one, you want to make it a little lower than what you might normally do if you're just doing hypers for your lower back. That way you can get the weights actually over the machine. So for that, it is a full back workout, so you'll feel it in your lower back when you're coming down, and then when you're coming up, when you row, it'll be middle and upper back. That I did was, sorry, I'm just looking at my phone, was wide cable pull downs with a pause. And when I did it, you'll actually see in the videos, I supinated, which means I rotated my wrist. So I started with palm out, and then when I came in, I crunch and I turn my hand and I pull into it. And then I pause. You want to pause for like 1 to 2 seconds. There's an old guy gyrating behind me. That's okay. Sorry about that. We're just gonna block him with my head. So you want to supinate, and it will really help isolate and target your back. Josh and I are going to do some cardio. 45 minutes on the Stairmaster, level 11 for 45 minutes, and then eat, and then get home and work some more. So yeah, it's been a good workout. Let's go kill it on the Stairmaster.